Accordingly, from the time his abduction was known, our High Commission in Islamabad has continuously pressed Pakistan authorities for such access. Although this is provided for by international law and is deemed a norm in international relations, the government of Pakistan did not permit this. That itself should tell us much about the strength of the case against Shri Jadhav. Honorable members would also recall that a senior Pakistani leader has himself expressed doubts about the adequacy of evidence in this case. Madam Speaker, earlier this year, the Pakistan government sought our assistance to obtain evidence and other materials for this investigation process. In doing so, they leveled ridiculous charges against senior Indian officials who had no connection to this issue. Thereafter, they linked providing consular access to our acceptance of their position. Nevertheless, in the hope that some forward movement could be made, our response was constructive. We pointed out that consular access to Shri Jadhav would be an essential prerequisite in order to verify the facts and understand the circumstances of his presence in Pakistan. Madam Speaker, given this exchange, it is extraordinary that yesterday a decision is suddenly announced awarding a death sentence in this case, when previous exchanges with India itself underlines the insufficiency of evidence. To make matters even more absurd, 3 hours after the death sentence was announced, the Indian High Commission received an official communication from the Foreign Ministry of Pakistan reiterating the Pakistani proposal for conditional consular access. That tells us a lot about the farcical nature of the alleged proceedings, which have led to an indefensible verdict against an innocent kidnapped Indian citizen. Madam Speaker, our position on this matter is very clear. There is no evidence of wrongdoing by Shri Jadhav. If anything, he is the victim of a plan that seeks to cast aspersions on India to deflect international attention from Pakistan's well-known record of sponsoring and supporting terrorism. Under these circumstances, we have no choice but to regard the sentence, if carried out, as an act of premeditated murder. Madam Speaker, yesterday Foreign Secretary conveyed our position to the High Commission of Pakistan. Let me state clearly that the government and people of India would view very seriously the possibility that an innocent Indian citizen is facing death sentence in Pakistan without due process and in violation of basic norms of law, justice and international relations. I would caution the Pakistan government to consider the consequences of our bilateral relationship if they proceed on this matter. Madam Speaker, I have been in touch with the parents of Shri Jadhav and we are extending our fullest support to them in this difficult situation. A strong sense of solidarity expressed by this House will give them more courage and strength at this time. Thank you.